Alright, hello ladies and gentlemen, it's VMP, welcome back. This time we're here with a little more of our Prophecy of Pendor series, and we knew the piece was not going to last too long, but damn, this was pretty damn quick. The Empire just declared war against us. Now, to preface this, we were waiting a little bit. It has been a couple weeks since the last episode, maybe 2 weeks, if that. It hasn't been long. But I guess we're going to have to go against them. Let's take a quick look at this. Alright. It's not looking great. Ethos, the city that we have our custom knighthood order in, is absolutely surrounded. So that's the bad news. Good news is, Empire doesn't look to be too strong right now. If you look at them, they only have 3 big towns. And then, how many castles do they have? They have a fair amount of castles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 castles. If we wanted to go balls to the wall, we could probably take them out in this war altogether. Probably not going to do that? Probably not. Although, I guess we'll see how it goes. I'm not sure how strong these garrisons are, but they just finished up a war with Ravenstern, which even after we hurt them, I'm sure Ravenstern is still the strongest faction in the game. Yeah. So, that couldn't have been great on them, and they were fighting with Saleon. They've basically constantly been in wars. I'm gonna look. Does it say why they're trying to fight us? Declared war to regain some lost territory. Ah. Yep. They want Ethos back. Okay. Well, and also good news, all of these should basically be safe. I can't see them making a trip all the way up there. Plus, with our Mist Mountain armies guarding Poinsbrook and Rain, we should be okay. Now, the only problem is we have to get down there with an army. Alright, let's go ahead and handpick an army. Actually, this might be a good opportunity to use the Crusade. In fact, I kind of like that idea. Let me think. It's the beginning of a war. There's going to be plenty of opportunities to fight. The Crusade gives me a bunch of free knights. I'm not seeing any downsides to this. Sure, it would only be 100 or so, but that should be enough to defend a siege if that's what happens, and even take out a bunch of their little lords, and then once we're done with that, we can go ahead and come in with a big army and just clean up. That seems like a pretty solid plan to me. So what happened in between episodes? We did finish reading the High Arts book. We're kind of low on food, too. Yeah, we finished reading the High Arts, so that gave us +1 intelligence. We're starting to read this Memories of a Pendorian Commander. That's probably going to give us tactics, which we don't really need, I don't think, because we already are at a... Well, I guess we're at a 9, so that would be nice. Okay, so, let us... So we have that one extra skill point. Eventually we're going to want, obviously, like 10 surgery, 10 first aid, all those are important. Engineer wouldn't be the worst, but we have it at 0 right now, so that's a whole lot of... points we'd have to put in there. Prisoner management might actually be kind of nice. I was instinctively going to go with like horse archery or shield or even athletics, but now that I'm looking at it, prisoner management might be the better idea. Reduces the chances of lords escaping after battle, and I think that includes unique spawns. Let me think. I mean, that'd be pretty nice. That would be pretty nice. Crap, I wasn't going to do that. I wanted to increase our shield and whatnot. You know what, but I think this is the smarter choice in the long run. Alright, we'll go ahead and do that. Okay, let's go ahead and get this crusade going. You know, the Rodok crusade that we participated in on Saturday? Didn't go so well. Hopefully this one will go a little bit better. We're not going against the OP Serenids. We should be okay. Alright. I am looking for a more challenging task. Alright, I'll win victories for you guys. Now we're probably going to have to get a lot of renown for this, so I might turn down the battle size and the settings. Whoops, oh, just visiting the town a little bit. Let me see how much renown. If it's like 300 some, we're probably going to do that. 255. I guess we'll play it by ear. We'll see how it's going. Yep, they are already laying waste to all of our towns down here. Okay, let's head over there. So, also good thing about fighting with the Empire right now is that they only have two towns, so we're only losing income from those two towns. What? Those guys already getting taken out? It's kind of embarrassing. Should we bring Frederick with us? I don't think we really need him. This is kind of more of a scouting mission, so to speak. We'll check out what their castles have, see what we're going to be looking to take out in future episodes. And right now we're looking to take out a bunch of their lords, hold them prisoner, see how it's going. And probably defend off a siege here, I'm going to guess, because we don't have too many troops stationed here at Ethos. We don't have that many. Yep, and there it's besieged. All right, let's get over there quick. Raymond Stern to Char made peace, okay. Alright, who do we got here? Hello. And especially with Empire troops, we're definitely going to want to fight them in the field. Because they are terrible in the field. Actually, a little scary in sieges, which is not why I'm not looking forward to having to defend Ethos, but... Alright, let's take this dude out right here. Yeah, he's running from us. They ain't got shit on us. We're definitely going to catch him. Holy shit, we're going 6.4 speed. Look at that. Oh, he likes us. Let us... Let's talk. What do you think in general terms about kings, lords, and politics? Or how do you feel about Myrus and Pyrder? I think it's this one. Okay, he's an honorable dude. How do you feel about him? Damn it. Nope. He's not. Okay. Alright. Alright, sorry, man. We gotta fight again. No, it's gonna have to happen. We are at war. Alright, let's do this. Come on, lads. Let's crush them. What he said. Ooh. Gotta get back used to this OP bow. I've been doing a little bit of multiplayer. Not used to having a bow that fires like a goddamn sniper rifle. And kills him like that as well. Get out of here. Get out of here. ooh, ouch. That hurt, crossbowman. That hurt a little bit. Not enough, though. Oh, yeah, they're getting crushed. I didn't see how much renown are we getting for this battle. Hopefully a decent amount. Although, we do have quite the powerful army with us. So even though we're taking out a lord with 170 troops, which is no laughing matter, we're probably not going to be getting as much renown as we'd probably hope. Which is fine. It's what we get for having this OP of an army. And we're not losing any troops, really? Oh, fuck, Anson's in the battle. God damn it. I'm going to have to make sure to change that. Luckily, this is kind of a warm-up battle for us, so we shouldn't be losing too many troops with him knocked out. Alright, let's just keep this going. Oh yeah, we're crushing through these guys pretty quick. Looks like we got a bunch of armsmen and whatnot. Ooh, gladiator. Some good units here undercover. This dude. Oh yeah, these guys. 735 experience. I don't know how they're worth that much. But okay. What else? Oh, okay, something else happened in between the episodes. So, I think we sent Sigismund Sinclair to train all of our Knighthood Order units for 3 weeks, and he came back. Not a lot was trained during there. Basically, all of their Iron Flesh, their Power Strike, I think maybe even their Power Draw, I think all that went up by one. Our actual Knights, their Agility went up by two, but that was about it, and a little bit of Proficiency. So it wasn't great, to be honest. It looks like it's going to take a lot longer than I thought. Alright, how much? We got 27 renown for that. It's not a lot. We'd have to take out how many more, if that was the case? We'd have to take out, it'd be 8 battles just like that. Which I suppose is definitely feasible. Especially for us. Because we didn't take any losses in that battle. We'll see, though. I doubt they will all be as easy to fight as this guy. Although, why does he all of a sudden have a whole ton of horsemen? I have no idea. I mean to get to the bottom of this. Oh, hello. Get out of here, Empire Immortal. There's another one. Why? He had all of his elite troops right in the back of his group. Interesting. It's normally the opposite. Guess he subscribes to the fodder method of thinking. Let the weak troops go in first and let them die. Soften them up. Fortunately for him, they didn't soften us up really at all. Like, not at all. There we go. Alright, well, that's a pretty good start to this war. Oh yeah, and the prisoner management, honestly, alright, I'm confident in that decision now, because with this war, we are gonna be wanting to take as many lords prisoner as possible. Obviously that didn't happen, but it will hopefully help in the future. We forgot to get food, didn't we? Oh well, hopefully when we get to Ethos, we can do that. Does anyone want this stuff? It's some pretty good armor. No? Okay. Well, we'll sell it nonetheless. I know we're rich, but we're not rich enough to turn down a 5,000 plus suit of armor to sell. Oh yeah, 349? These are some pretty small garrisons in their castles. I'm not afraid of that at all. How many troops? Holy shit! Okay, let's do a quick count. Oh my god. How many lords is this? 8 lords here. See, we got 250. About another 200 right there. 350. Say 50 there. 400. About 700. We're looking at about 800 to 900 troops here. Okay. Well. Closer to 900. That's a lot of troops, huh? Although we do have, I didn't realize, we actually have 283 troops stationed here. That's more than I thought. So we actually, with our army, would have 420. That's enough, especially we have a tactics of what now? Tactics of 12. I mean, should be okay. I'm sure that's higher than whatever they have. Well, yeah, it has to be higher. The max they can have is 10. Okay, whoops, actually didn't want to go to the tavern, but I guess we might as well check it out. Maybe there are a few mercenaries we can hire. Ooh, Sir Alistair. I think we might want to hire him. Just so that we can make him a lord. Okay, I needed a drink to steady my nerves. I came upon a dead girl outside of town. Her heart had been ripped from her breast. Whoa. The heretics must have been at work again, the bastards. I simply stumbled upon the poor girl and quickly ascertained that she was beyond any help I could give. I'm the younger son of a high lord in Barclay, Farrick the Noxious. What kind of lord name is that, the Noxious? That's terrible. Come to Pendor, like many other knights, to make my name and fortune. I was dodging a party of those sanctimonious twits of the dawn when I tripped over the girl. You don't happen to know if they're heading this direction, do you? If so, I must depart immediately, and I advise you to do the same. They are deadly enemies to my order, and will likely attack you as well. They take rather unreasonable dislikes very quickly. Alright. The Order of the Dawn was tactically expelled from Barclay because of the atrocities they committed upon the populace there, burning villages, putting peasants, merchants, and even the nobility to death by fire to cleanse them of what those zealots deemed as their sins. Oh, that's right. I remember now. Sir Alistair is a member of the Order of Eventide. Basically, he's actually almost a member of the heretics themselves. And I'm not surprised they don't like the Order of the Dawn. Well, $5,000? We can afford $5,000 for a knight like yourself. All right, let's get out of here. Marketplace, give me some food, give me the good news. Okay, we got a decent amount of food here, we should be good, and we might even be able to sell some of this. Yeah, it's worth some good money. And we might even be able to get another wagon train, or baggage train, or whatever they're called out here. Who do we need to talk to? Look at our very manly person and our vicious motherfucking Pandorians. They're not looking too great yet, but they are a little bit stronger than last episode. A little bit stronger. We have Julia training them now, because she has really good power draw as well, and they're going to need that sooner or later. Definitely recruit from the surrounding villages for a month, and then let me get a baggage train. Thank you very much. Alright, yeah, that's good. Okay. So I guess, do we just wait here? Wait for them to come in and attack us? There. Boris the Raven has gathered a company of Raven Spear Knights and joined King Gregory IV. Oh, they left. Oh, nope. JK. Oh, who are they fighting? Who are you fighting? Are those just farmers? If they're farmers, they're fucked. We're leaving them. Can't even tell. Let me look. Oh, 209. Holy shit. Is that one of my... Fuck, that's one of my vassals, and there's 1,000 of them. Crap, I think someone else just joined them as well. Who all is in here? Not the actual king, by any means. Jesus, do we want to fight them in the field? That seems like a terrible decision. Like, at least in the siege, we just have to fend off one or two waves of them, and then they go back. Oh, man. We're really gonna... No, we can't do that. I'm sorry, whoever that is. Yon Yon. What's going on here? Hello. Your very manly people have acquired the new Knight Surcoat Dark. Ah, very nice. Okay, let us, in that case... Actually, we might... Yeah, look at them. They're looking a little bit better. Still wearing leather boots and whatnot. Tell me of your skills. Strength 11, not the greatest. We actually might not want to upgrade them for the time being, because we can't even give them the best armor in the game or anything, because they don't have the skills yet. Like these guys. Strength of 19, agility 14, not the worst, but they're still not there yet. Well, they did increase their one-handed weapon proficiency. So I think we're going to refrain from upgrading them until they have enough strength to be able to use, like, the Noldor armor and weaponry. Because otherwise, we're just kind of wasting money, I suppose. Alright, but hold up. First things first, Anson, you are going to the back, my friend. 54 Knights of the Dragon, 84 Dragon Drakes. This feels like the largest crusade they've given us yet. Oh, it's a vicious motherfucking Pandoran war party. Oh man, they're gonna get crushed! They're wearing, like, leather! That's the saddest Knighthood Order war party I've seen in my life. Alright, let's see if we can't fight this dude, though. He kind of got caught out. Livius Dux, get over here. Oh, yeah. Oh, he does not like us. I could have him out of the way in a jiffy, with none the wiser as to how it happened. Just say the word. Well, Lothaldrin, I kind of like your way of thinking. But I think we're going to fight this guy the right way. And he seems to be quite dishonorable, so if we do get him, it would appear that we'd get some ransom money out of him, that's for certain. We're not letting him go. Where's crossbowmen out there? They are. Can't tell if we're getting close or not. Oh yeah, we are. There we go. Hit him. Killed him. Killed him. Nope, didn't kill him. There's some strong-ass crossbowmen. Get fucked. Get out of here, Empire Knights. You're not even a real knight. They're like the Vagers in the real Mountain Blade. They're not real knights. You just call yourself knights. Just drive-by slaughter. That's what I'm talking about. Ooh, we murdered that horse. 320 damage. Oh, he's running back at us? What, are you gonna charge us with your sword? Get out of here. Get out of here. Down you go. Now we can just feast on these dudes with a bow. That's what I'm talking about. Nope. Where are you going? Whatever. He can live. That dude will not... Ooh. You look pretty strong. Oh, you survived a shot. Oh, you're an Empire mortal, aren't you? Ow, fuck. Oh, look, we actually lost a troop. That's a first. Other than that, we seem to be slaughtering them. Oh, man, I guess fighting that army of 1,000 would be a decent way to get some renown, wouldn't it? And now it's only like 900, because we took out this lord. I am tempted. I am very tempted. Problem is, I feel like if we fight that army of 1,000, we're definitely going to be losing a decent amount of troops. We got 15 renown for that. Hmm. 982. There's still so many of them. I tell you what, we're going to help them a little bit. I'm not saying we're going to save them, because honestly, they're not really worth being saved. But we're going to get 55 renown for this, so we can hopefully try to do a couple waves here and be good. Let's go in, men. Yeah, look at our Knighthood Order units. That's so pathetic. It's honestly a little depressing to watch them. They have quarter staves. Couldn't even afford to give them swords yet. Sooner or later we will. What the hell? Is that a Fierdsvane Barbarians? What the hell are they doing here? Must have had some lords defecting. This is actually a pretty terrifying group of enemies if you think about it. Oh my god, they're going at me. They are going at me. Kill this barbarian. Alright, we got him. Is it barbarian? Berserker, my bad. Same thing, to be honest, but... Holy shit, yeah, this is not good at all. Alright, we're just gonna go in, try to kill some bitches and help out. Gotta break this off a little bit. Yeah, this is why I didn't want to go in. They have enough troops that it's actually not the best for us. So many vicious Pendorians going down. Actually not losing too many of our Knighthood Order units, but they must have taken a lot of the Fierdsvane lords in after Fierdsvane went down, because they have a whole bunch of these Berserkers. Alright, we're killing a bunch of them, though. We might actually win this battle after all, but it is not going to be without casualties. That is for certain. Ooh, this horse is nearly dead. Let me keep that in mind. I might pick up one of these ones. Actually, I think we might go to head over to Laria and pick up a Noldor spirit horse, if they have any. Just so we have an armored horse that's still fast as shit. Oh, Jesus, we just got hit at that by the worst possible time. Alright, it might be time to peace on out of here. This is a bit much. Yeah, we need to fight them in a siege. There's no way we're going to take them out like this. Alright, we're going before we're losing too many of our own units. Peace! Okay, what do we lose? We only lost 3. Yeah, that's not bad at all. Like I said, it was mainly these guys getting fucked. Let's get out of here. To run from battle like this? Okay, your objection is noted, but, I mean, it wasn't going too well. I'm not trying to get all of us slaughtered. No, we did some damage. Alright, we're gonna wait here. Let them continue their siege and come back. Oh, nope, they're going? Are they gone? Is that official? Are they fighting some Noldor? Alright. Could stand to get some more relationship with the Noldor. Not to mention, these guys are already would have been fucked by the Rangers. Alright, we're good to go. I'm going to be really sad if to get the best armor in the game we really do have to go ahead and take out the Eldarion Lord. That's going to be so much time. Really not looking forward to it, but oh well. So there's not too much we can do about it. Oh yeah, these guys... See, it's when they're by themselves they're so weak. It's just when they've got, you know, 9 or 10 lords together. And what are we gonna do with that? We've got so many elite troops. They had like probably at least 150, 200 elite troops that we can't feasibly try to go through all of them without losing half of our men. I'm gonna say that was a pretty big war party of our knights, though. Like that was like 200 of them. If you think about it, like, imagine that in the end game when these knights are gonna be OP as shit. It's not too shabby. Not too shabby at all. Alright. Took him out. Noldor loving us even more. I wonder what happens when we get up to 100 with them. Guess we'll see. Why don't we sell any of this stuff? No idea. Okay. Let's go. You're welcome, Noldor. Please feel free to come back anytime and fight some more with these lords. Alright, we seem to have fended off the siege for now. Tell you what, let's take a look at these castles in a sec. But before we do that, I'm going to check out Savador and then Janos. Savador Castle? What are we talking about here? Ooh, hello, Lord. Alright, we're definitely going to take Sir Roland's side, because Sir Alistair is a temporary member of this party. Oh, he's running from us. That's never a good sign for them. Okay, so once again, about 350 troops in these castles. That's very takeable. Very, very takeable. Okay. I'm not gonna bother chasing after that lord. He only has 49 troops, not really worth it. So let's check out, ooh, hello, some lords over here. Are they running from us? Or, no, they're traveling to Yano, so they say. Seems to me that they might be running from us. What does this dude have? Oh, here's the one with all the berserkers. I wouldn't mind actually taking them out. If we could. Oh, and he has a bunch of our troops. A bunch of our knighthood order guys. Prisoner. Alright, we'll consider fighting him in a sec. Otherwise, let's take out Lord Antonius, maybe? This would be a pretty big battle here, but I don't mind taking it. See a couple lords over there. There's Marius Imperator, and he has a mercenary army with him. Look at our spotting skill. Our spotting skill is on point. Bunch of Melatine. Interesting. Okay. Well, we'll take him out. Hopefully none of the rest of them get in with it except for that dude. That's fine. Oh, some of the farmers join their side. Alright, I guess we'll see how that goes for them. Okay. Only 263. I feel like we got this. Yeah, 28 renown. Not too shabby. We'll get a couple rounds after this. And see what the tactics was. What our tactics advantage was. If we even have one. Is this a Sarleon Lord? What is this? Oh, Knights of the Falcon. Interesting. Haven't seen them in a bit. Honestly, we haven't seen many of these troops in a while. It's been all Ravensturm for the last, like, 10 episodes. Up until this. Which I am absolutely fine with. I was getting sick of all those Ravenstern units. What a whiff that was. Thought we'd at least get the horse. Alright, we're trouncing these guys. What a joke. What a joke. Sure, we can't fight your army of 1,000 head-on, but looks like we're going to be taking them out one by one, two by two, whatever it is. Whatever it might be. Get wrecked. Oh, they killed a Knight of the Dragon. We're gonna have to upgrade them eventually. We haven't spent any money upgrading them yet. Might be worth it just to put a little bit into them. Maybe like 30,000, 70,000, depending on how many times we want to upgrade them. Just get them a little bit beefier. Take a little more damage, deal a little bit more. So that's all we need. Oh, you dodged it. Oh, you dodged it again. I guess you survived then. Definitely need to get back used to this bow, though. I was playing some Full Invasion 2, which I think I might actually do a video on that at some point. That is a really fun mod. Like, I had a feeling that it'd be fun for the longest time, but I had never tried it. Then I actually tried it. And man, that thing's pretty sweet. There's a lot of cool stuff on there. Especially if you can get a big party playing with you. Like, if you can get, like, 30, 40 guys on the defense, oh my god, you can go, like, you can last for, like, 20, 30 waves. It gets pretty hectic. It's pretty fun. But their bows are nowhere near as fast as this one. Ooh! That snipe, though. We're almost done? Oh, there's another one. Another Valkyrie. Or Lady Ianhar, whatever they're called. Ah, she's dead. Rip. Very good battle. Very good indeed. We only lost, what, one? Two troops? Two troops. Two Knights of the Dragon. Got a bunch of renown. And now we will... Can we get through here alright? We can retreat if they're like right on us here. Nah, we're good. We're good. Let's go. Alright. So let's take these guys out. Scout out Yanos. And then I think we might go... We'll go to Laria. We'll pick up our nice horse. And then... Oh yeah, look at these guys. They are all scrubs. All scrubs. Can you even hurt me? Can do a little bit of damage, but not much. So we're just gonna sit here, crush through their shields, crush through their skulls, one and the same. Kicking ass and taking names. That's what we do. Come on. There we go. Man, these guys are weak as fuck. Bunch of weak Beardsbane units. Did I see a horseman? I do see horsemen. You guys are not going to lead us on a chase. Let me tell you that. Not going to get very far at all. Ooh, Queen Agnes Freebooters. It's this lord that we're fighting. I really want to know the story behind those troops. Like, that's a pretty interesting name. Queen Agnes Freebooter. I really want to know the story behind that. It's probably on the wiki. We good? Yeah, there we go. Ooh, look at that. Proficiency in one-handed, 409. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Get wrecked. Okay. Alright, last 18 troops. Quick finish these guys off. But yeah, so we can go ahead, go to Laria, pick up the really nice horse, and then I think it should be about time for a Noldor tournament. If not, we can probably wait for it. I think. I'll have to see what day it is. But yeah, I think that's a pretty good game plan for the time being. These are just the weakest Beardsbane units. I think the only reason we lost that big battle was just because they had 100 and 200 elite units right up front. If we had gone past those guys, it would have been clear sailing. So maybe we should have, but I feel like we would have lost a lot of troops. As it is, we got out of there only losing two. And... or two or three. Took out 50 of them. So we didn't really lose much. Oh, you are very dishonorable, which means you are my prisoner. And you escaped. Good for you. Okay. Oh, here we go. Some more decent money there. Alright, let's get out of here. Very nice indeed. What is Yanos looking like? Hello, Marius Imperator. Guardian Empire Knights, 43. 31 regular Empire Knights. He's not... I mean, he's not weak, obviously. That's a pretty good army. But it's not... he's not, like, unbearably strong. Could probably fight him. What is Yanos looking like? Oh, hello. 774 and a whole bunch of lords. Okay. Yanos might take a bit to take them out. Alright, let's quick take this guy out right here. Then we'll go ahead and head over to Laria. We do have 6 days. I can just fast forward through that and then do the Noldor tournament for us. Oh, is he going to get some people to help him? No, he's not. Oh, poor dude. Hey, Anson. What is going on? Guys, stop fucking talking. Right, surrender or die. Jesus. Not sure what the hell they were saying. But yeah, I'm definitely going to want to take this dude out. He looks like he has a very nice army, and I want to stop him from getting even more elite troops. From what I saw, he had a lot of knights. Empire mortals, I think I saw a few of them. Saw some gladiators. Just in general. Not the type of dudes, not the type of troops we want to be seeing a lot of in the future. I'm fine with the lords like the other ones that are like all Beardsbane troops. That's fine by me. Bring them in. Bunch of Empire Knights. Well, not the greatest. Well, not even really knights. Still don't want to fight a bunch of them. Oh yeah, we just clean them right on up. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, hello. Hello. Uh-oh. You lost your horse. Is this guy trying to help you? Not going to get the chance. Oh, look at all these crossbowmen trying to run. It's a pity they didn't get to use any of their bolts. Come up, boys. Come up. God, Dragon's Flame is really getting OP. As our weapon proficiency continues to go up, we are just continuing to do more and more damage with it. Boom. So nice. Alright. There we go. Took him out. Okay, he's a pretty honorable dude. We're going to go ahead and let him go. Boom. Yeah, he's an honorable dude. Unfortunately, in the off-season, that's what we're going to call the peacetime, the off-season, we didn't get a chance to recruit any lords, but I guess, you know, not the biggest deal. We can look to do that after this war, maybe. Okay. What do I want to do? Do we have anything to build here? No? Okay. Let's just go ahead and sell some stuff off, then. We got attacked. Ouch! Fuck me, that hurt. What? Group of bandits? These don't look like bandits to me. Ouch. They're assassins. They're not bandits at all. Hello. What the f... Did we just get hit by somebody? We must have. Where's he at? Oh, no. Huh. Alright. Let us... Marketplace, that's what we're doing. I kind of lost my train of thought there. We got attacked, after all. Dried meat, we can afford it. Sausages, sure. Give me all that. All that good stuff. Very nice. Do we want to sell this? Don't really need to. Could probably put it in our chest, but... I don't know. Ethos might get taken here. It's not 100% that we're going to keep it, so... We're not going to do that for the time being. Let's head up to Laria. All right, we'll head over here. Go ahead and do the tournament real quick. Should be good to go. We'll see. We'll keep an eye on the notifications. We'll see if we get a... What? Really don't care about you, Sir Alistair. I'm just here to make you a lord, which you should be happy about. Alright, Tavern. Quigfin, my mans. How you doing? Alright, arms and armor. What do you got for me? Spirited Noldor Spirit Horse. That's all I was looking for. Look at this thing, guys. Look at it. 70 armor. 52 speed. 37 maneuver. 36 charge and 190 hit points. That's what I'm talking about. That's what we want. It's pretty good armor here. Not gonna lie. That's like what we have a set of being upgraded. But... It's going to be even better than that soon. Alright, yeah, I think we just go ahead and buy this horse here. Alright, so we'll put you down here, and we'll get you. 95,000. It's a lot of money. Putting 100 G's on this. But we got a lot of money. We'll still have 200,000 left over. Plus, we're still making money. So, I think we can afford that. We can definitely afford that. Alright, there you go. Boom. Take it, my mans. I cannot wait to try this horse out. Probably not going to get a chance to try it out this episode. We'll try it out next episode, though. It's all good. All right. Yeah, I guess we'll just go over to Elecrae and wait for this. Oh, yeah. We're still making nearly 10 grand a week. We are fine. This war with... Oops. They're laying waste to a bunch of our towns and whatnot. That's fine. But this war with empires is not hurting us too much financially. I don't care about that. Dishar against Sarleon. Interesting. Not really of too much importance to us, though I guess every war is kind of important to us now that we are... Yep, Sir Roland, you have my support. Don't you worry about it. We're gonna get rid of Sir Alistair pretty quick here. Tell you what, we might actually just... Huh, let me think. Do we have any fiefs that we can give him? We don't have a castle yet, but we can just give him a town for the time being and get him off our hands. I think I kind of like that. What is their skills like? Not too great. I mean, not bad, but... Oops. Let's just go ahead and give him a fief. Anything that's not assigned yet? No? Alright, let's give him one of these new ones that's being raided. Yeah, you have Dirigine. There we go. Alright, get out of here. Okay, a couple more days. We're going to be seeing a lot of notifications of all of our fiefs getting raided over there. Ah, fuck, they besieged it again, huh? Not going to let us get away with it, huh? Might be next episode, then. Holy shit, Aethelrander. You're terrifying. If we're going to fight one of you, it's definitely going to be Eldarion. Only has 500. Although, significantly more Noldor. He actually doesn't have as many Noldor. We might actually want to fight him. Probably not still, though. Damn, he has 150 Cobra Warriors, 170 Snakehold Armsmen, and 200-some Snakehold Followers, something like that. That is pretty insane. All right, let's head back to Ethos. We'll probably defend this next episode. It's getting pretty late. Oh, yeah, they're back. Not really enforced, though. Not nearly as many as last time, although that is a pretty large group right there. We got about 300. 300 plus 550. Carry the one. You know, we're talking about 700 troops right now. So not as many as last time, but still a significant amount. Oh, is he going in? No, he's following the farmers. Is this dude really trying to fight me by himself? I didn't think so. Oh, now you're coming back at me. Huh? I think we're good here. Oh, yeah. That was a mistake, my mans. That was a mistake. Alright, we'll finish up with this battle. And then we should be good to go. Next episode should be interesting. We'll definitely take out one of those weaker castles that is nearby us. Probably give that to Lord Alistair, so we have at least one lord that's invested in our empire territories. And providing us a little bit of backup. Obviously, we don't need it, but, you know, helpful. Helpful nonetheless. Boom. Boom. I almost kind of forgot that we're still on the crusade here. This crusade, honestly, is one of the most helpful features in the game. When it comes to wars. To be able to just get an army of 150 knights for free is amazing. Do we even have to pay weekly wages for them? We might not even have to pay weekly wages for them. It's great. We certainly don't have to pay weekly wages for all the troops that were in our party. Oops. Couldn't make up our mind there. There you go. And you... Right in the face. That was the money shot right there, boys. That was the money shot. Oops. My bad, Knight of the Dragon. Good thing you already had a lot of hit points, so we didn't actually take you out. We've been doing a really good job. I just want to point this out. We've been doing a really good job of not killing or knocking out our own troops recently. I know, you know, that's probably not the biggest accomplishment for most people. But for us, it's kind of a big... It's kind of a big accomplishment. I'll go ahead and say that. The defeated lord genuinely admires both you and your kingdom. Hello. Hello. Oh my. Well then. Lord Leonius. And he's a decently honorable guy. That is interesting. That's very interesting. I almost want to... Nah, we'll go ahead and set him free for right now. That's pretty interesting. I like that. Alright, guys. Well, I think we're going to go ahead and leave it off here. Next episode, we should have a pretty interesting battle on our hands. We got about 600 troops right outside Ethos. So we're either going to have a pretty baller siege going on, or we might engage them in the field. I'm not sure. But until then, as always, guys, leave me some comments down below. Let me know what you think about this series and all the rest of the series that are going on right now. Just look at... there's Sir Alistair's fief. You're welcome. You're a lord now. You are the lord of this burning village. But yeah, as always, guys, take it easy.